Thank you. share with you, and we are very excited about the repertoire that we have selected for you tonight. So this first piece that you heard is something that you don't really hear that often. This Rondo in B-flat major is rarely performed, and it was written by a young and spirited Mozart, 19-year-old Mozart. Actually, he wrote it as a substitute for the last movement of his first concerto. And it is usually performed with orchestra, and in fact, you can hear Ching perform with orchestra this Saturday, if you're in the neighborhood. Where are you playing, Ching?
Baltimore Symphony, but just go online. But this is a little piece, he wrote a few rondos. I think the underage kids, this is for student level playing. It's really very beautiful to learn, to start to learn how to play Mozart. And it's also not easy, it's a little bit tricky.
It's tricky, yeah. That's right. So we are going to move on now to another piece which perhaps is not that often heard, and that is the Janáček Sonata for Violin and Piano. Janáček wrote it in 1914 at the beginning of the First World War. So it was a time obviously heavily burdened for Janáček and for the rest of Europe. And on top of it, he was dealing with his personal tragedy a few years before his daughter passed away, Olga, which is something that he never recovered from. So the piece is very dramatic, very intense, and also as a form sort of nebulous. It is rooted in Moravian folklore and in speech patterns. It's something that Janáček was absolutely fascinated with, including language rhythms inside of his music. So you're going to hear these short patterns that keep coming back over and over again throughout the piece in all four movements, and they represent different speech patterns coming from the folklore. Ching, anything you'd like to add?
No, that's fine.
Okay, Janáček then.
Thank you.
So the last tour we were on, it was West Texas. There was 7 to 9 concerts within 7-8 days. So, but I keep apologizing to Volodymyr because these Janacek, I keep last moment, I keep interrupting him. That's so what was I going to talk about? Actually, nothing. Just we rehearse very little, but we work, perform a lot. So it's more of what for the students is if you can listen more, and a lot of problems will solve it. Of course, you have to learn your part, but when you're playing chamber music, you're playing with partners, it's all about listening and be a good musician, which is most of our musical adult life is about listening.
That's right. Yes, I completely agree. And I must say also trusting one's partner is so important, as I do trust Ching 100%. So I'm very fortunate to play with such a wonderful musical partner. I hope you enjoy the Janacek. It's, as I said, an unusual, rarely performed piece in 4 movements with so much drama and angst inside. The second movement, which maybe you heard, sort of on its own because its character was so dreamy, sweet, and lullaby-like, is called Ballade, and in fact was the first movement which Janacek composed, and then he strung the others together around that ballade. So we decided to copy the program from our West Texas tour here. So in that spirit, we are going to move on to Schubert as a big contrast to the Janacek. It's interesting actually to compare Schubert Rondo, which we'll play to you right now, and the Mozart Rondo, which we played, because both Mozart and Schubert broke their rondos when they were 19. And this Schubert's Rondo is probably one of the two pieces that works that are extremely extroverted and virtuosic, another one being the fantasy for violin. And Schubert wrote this piece for a young Bohemian virtuoso, by the name of Slavik, I believe, Josef Slavik, who Chopin called the second Paganini. So it really is quite a workout for Ching in particular, and somewhat for me. So you're going to hear 2 sections, the first one in the style of a French overture, the introduction, and then moving on to the rondo proper, with the theme, of course, repeating many times as it does in any proper rondo.
Thank you. Thank you.
That's the best music performance, the vocal cords, right? So we're trying to imitate human voices. So this is by Dvorak. It's the songs my mother taught me. It's also called Gypsy Song. It's transcription by Chrysler.
Yes, and also it's inspired by a song for voice and piano, which comes from a cycle titled Gypsy Songs. And the poem was written by an important Czech poet by the name of Alfred Hajduk. So I will read you the poem. Songs my mother taught me in the days long vanished, seldom from her eyelids were the teardrops banished. Now I teach my children each melodious measure. Oft the tears are flowing, oft they flow from my memory's treasure.
Thank you.
song by Manuel Ponce, and that's Estrelita. So it is a beautiful melody, a beautiful story attached to it about a lady in love looking at a star and asking the little star whether her chosen loves her back. So the star is supposed to come down and whisper to her on her ear. Thank you so much for making this happen and for being here. Thank you again.